claims it wasn't O.J. A Hamilton man says his brother is the one who killed Nicole Brown Simpson and her friend Ron Goldman, and now his story has been made into a documentary set to air on Investigation Discovery. But one woman we spoke with says not so fast. News 5's Karen Johnson joining us now from Hamilton with the story. Karen?
Well, Mike, the documentary is set to air Wednesday night, and it'll take viewers to Hamilton, here along Park Avenue. The narrator of the film is the brother of serial killer Glen Rogers. But another family member I spoke with for quite a while today says the allegations in the film made by Clay Rogers are just not true. Glen Rogers, currently on death row for a murder in Florida. The Hamilton native made local and national headlines in 1995 when he led police on a high-speed chase which ended in Richmond, Kentucky. Rogers is also suspected of killing at least 10 others and once claimed he had murdered 70 people.
I was about 11 years old. Glen was about 8.
Now his brother Clay Rogers, seen here narrating a documentary that will air on Investigation Discovery, claims Glen is also responsible for the 1994 deaths of Nicole Simpson and Ron Goldman.
He had shared bad things with me, so there was a bond there.
The documentary claims Glen told family members that he was working for Simpson and he was going to take her down. But in an exclusive phone interview with me, the Rogers, ex-sister-in-law Paula Rogers, who was married to their other brother Gary for 34 years, disputes Clay's allegations. Paula says Glen, quote, did not kill Nicole Simpson. He was in the area. He was in the same bar Nicole was, but he did not kill her. About Clay, Paula told me, this is a desperate cry for help. I don't understand why he's doing this to his own brother. She claims he is homeless right now. Nobody wants him. And several times in my interview, she said, Clay has always been a con man. We did some digging into his past and found he has an extensive criminal history out of Iowa. Drug charges, domestic abuse, parole violation in 2008. And just less than 3 months ago, he was in the Butler County Jail on burglary and theft charges.
And I did try reaching out to Investigative Discovery today about Paula's claims, but I have not yet heard back from anyone. The film is set to air Wednesday night. Reporting live in Hamilton, Karen Johnson.